My name's Miranda Cooper, and today I'll be doing Edmund's monologue from Long Day's Journey Tonight. You just shared a couple of high spots in your memories. Want to hear mine? They're all connected with the sea. Here's one. When I was on the Squarehead Square River bound for Buenos Aires, full moon in the tides, the old hooker driving 14 knots, I lay on the bowsprit, facing a stern, the water foaming into spume underneath me, the masts with every sail white in the moonlight towering high above me. I became drunk with the beauty and singing rhythm of it, and for a moment I lost myself, actually lost my life. I was set free. I dissolved in the sea, became white sails and flying spray, became beauty and rhythm, became moonlight and the ship and the dim starred sky. I belonged without past or future, within peace and unity and a wild joy, within something greater than my own life or the life of man, to life, to God himself, if you want to put it that way. Then another time on the American line, when I was on the crow's nest being a lookout in the dawn watch, a calm sea that time, only a lazy ground swell and the slow, drowsy roll of the ship. The passengers asleep, and none of the crew in sight, no sound of man. Black smoke pouring out of the funnels behind and beneath me. Dreaming, not keeping lookout, feeling alone and above and apart, watching the dawn creep in the sky and the sea we slept together. Then the moment of ecstatic freedom came, the peace, the end of the quest, last shore. The joy of belonging to a fulfillment beyond man's lousy, pitiful, greedy fears and hopes and dreams. And several other times in my life, like swimming out far into the sea or lying on the beach alone, I've had that same experience, like a saint's beatitude, like the veil of things as they seem drawn back by an unseen hand. For a second you see, and seeing the secret, or the secret for a second, there is meaning. Then the hand lets the veil fall and you're alone, lost back in the fog. And you stumble on towards nowhere for no good reason. It was a great mistake, my being born a man. I'd be more successful as a seagull or a fish. As it is, I will always be a stranger who never feels at home, who never really wants, or is really wanted, who can never belong, who must always be a little